Joining me now is foreign editor at The Australian and the author of the new book, Christians, The Urgent Case for Jesus in Our World, Greg Sheridan. Greg, welcome to the program.
Great to be with you, Chris.
It's true, isn't it? Merry Christmas is not universally said or exchanged anymore, and it's such a pity.
Well, you're absolutely right, Chris, and this certainly is an issue I explore in the book, Christians, the way our culture is turning its back on its Christianity and its Christian roots. What provoked a column of mine in the paper today was the European Commission, a body of the European Union, came up with a guide on inclusive language, and it forbade its officials from mentioning Christmas. It said, you must say the Christmas time can be stressful, and you must say the holiday period can be stressful. And it seems a trivial thing in a way, but you're not allowed to use, they said, don't use Christian names, don't use obviously Western Christian names if you're talking, generally about the public. Don't say John and Mary, use generic names like Malika and Julio or something. And the European Union is hostile to and ashamed of Europe's Christian roots. And I think this is a debilitating weakness for Western culture and a tragedy because a whole generation of Western kids are growing up without any knowledge of Christianity.
So I presume that we're becoming more secular. I get that, even in Europe. But despite that, why do we have to throw out our history? Why do we have to be ashamed of our past and our culture? Because that's what they're doing.
That's right, Chris. So Western civilization as we know it is completely a child of Christianity. Now, Christianity, again, as I explore in this book, Christians, is a universal religion. It's open to everyone. Majority of Christians today are not Westerners. But it is also the case that everything we like in Western civilization comes not from a rejection of Christianity, but from Christianity. So the idea of universal human rights, you've got St. Paul's famous statement of universalism, there is neither Jew nor Greek, slave nor free, male nor female, you are all one in Christ Jesus. It's Christianity that introduced universalism into human civilization. It all came from Christianity. And now the official culture has become so hostile to Christianity that it's no longer honoured, it's no longer mentioned, and it's whited out of popular culture. I have a big chapter on popular culture in this book. Ask yourself, how many TV dramas or sitcoms do you ever see with a sympathetic Christian in it? And even in Australia, we at the last census, we were still slightly more than half people in Australia are professing Christians. We certainly don't get half the airtime or half the characters in sitcoms or half the space on TV or anything like that.
So is it overstating it to say that the West can't survive if Christianity falls?
Well, Chris, that's a melancholy conclusion which I've come to. So we are now in a pretty mortal competition with very vigorous, self-confident cultures, China, Russia, and Iran. In many ways, their societies, their economies, and so on, are more primitive than Western societies, but they're very self-confident. And in my column in The Australian today, I contrast the recruitment ads for Chinese and Russian army recruits as opposed to the new American ads, which are all about woke social liberalism, a little girl with two mothers, God bless her for having two mothers, but the whole ad is about shattering stereotypes and personal fulfillment. It's got nothing to do with fighting for your country or anything like that. Now, getting back to your main question, I believe that if our culture has no self-confidence and no self-belief, if it doesn't believe in itself, it will find it almost impossible to do two things, to mediate its internal conflicts and to deal with very aggressive other cultures which are full of self-confidence and full of self-belief. So I do think there is a big question mark, can the West survive without Christianity?